Here we want to solve the trig equation cosine squared x minus cosine x minus 2 equals 0. And we're not given a specific interval. We want to state all solutions. So what we'll do is solve this equation first on the interval from 0 to 360 degrees. And then we'll write an expression from there to state all solutions. The next thing to notice about this equation is that it's in quadratic form, meaning if we let y equal cosine x, we could rewrite this as y squared minus y minus 2 equals 0. So if you're able to solve this type of quadratic equation by factoring, you should also be able to solve this trig equation by factoring. So this will factor into two binomials. But instead of having factors of y in the first positions, we'll have factors of cosine x. And the second positions will be from the factors of negative 2 that add to the coefficient of the middle term or add to negative 1. So the factors of negative 2 that add to negative 1 will be negative 2 and positive 1. So if we're multiplying these together and their product is equal to 0, cosine x minus 2 must equal 0, or cosine x plus 1 must equal 0. And now we'll solve these equations for cosine x. We'll add 2 here. We're going to have cosine x equals 2. And here we'll have cosine x equals negative 1. Now let's see if we can determine the angles that have these cosine function values. This first one's a little suspicious. The maximum value for the cosine function is positive 1. And we can think of this in two ways. We know on the unit circle that cosine theta is equal to x. And the largest value of x on the unit circle is positive 1. So cosine x is never going to equal positive 2. That doesn't mean there's no solution to this equation. That just means we don't have a solution from this factor. Another way to emphasize this is to take a look at the graph of cosine theta on the coordinate plane. Remember, the period for the cosine function is 2 pi radians, or 360 degrees. And then we divide the interval into 4 equal parts. Cosine theta at 0 is equal to 1. The next fourth, we're at the midline. The next fourth is a minimum of negative 1, back up to the midline and back up to the maximum. So here's the graph of the basic cosine function on the interval from 0 to 2 pi, or from 0 to 360 degrees. And notice how it never reaches a function value of 2. But we can find an angle that has a cosine function value of negative 1. The x-coordinate is equal to negative 1 here on the unit circle, which means the terminal side of the angle in center position would be here. The initial side would be here. And so when theta is pi radians, cosine theta is equal to negative 1. So let's express it both in radians and degrees. X is equal to 180 degrees, or x is equal to pi radians. And then again, referring to the graph of the basic cosine function, here we have a function value of negative 1 that occurs at pi radians. But remember, this question asks us to state all solutions, not just on a specified interval. So any angle that's coterminal to 180 degrees would also be a solution, which means all solutions could be expressed as 180 degrees plus 360 degrees times k, where k is some integer, meaning k is 0 plus or minus 1 plus or minus 2. Remember, 360 degrees represents an additional revolution from 180 degrees. And then if we want all solutions in radians, it would just be pi plus 2 pi times k, since 2 pi radians is equal to 360 degrees. So even when you're asked to determine all solutions of a trig equation, my suggestion is to limit the interval from 0 to 360 degrees and then determine all of the angles that would be coterminal to the solutions that you find. I hope you found this helpful.